Risk analysis is often presented as an arduous task that requires very specific skills and a lot of time. And yet, since we are kids, we spend our time doing this kind of analysis in our daily lives. Crossing a street, driving a motor vehicle, or even riding a bicycle are examples of situations where we will analyze the risks we face, prioritize them in terms of consequences, and draw a conclusion on how to avoid them. Are we going to cross the street or not? So why, in the workplace, when we are asked to do a risk analysis, we often feel that we are facing a huge mountain? Of course, understanding that crossing a street is equivalent to analyzing the risk of a routine task in a workplace may not be as easy as one may think. When we face a hazard, we often have two reactions, fight or flight. So, in the first case, we find a way to deal with the situation, and in the second, we move away from the situation. Risk analysis allows us to choose the best option for ourselves. It's important at this stage of the discussion to realize that everyone has a different perception of the risk, and therefore a risk tolerance of its own. It is quite possible that two individuals facing the same dangerous situation will react in opposite ways. Let's take a closer look at a given situation. You must cross a busy urban boulevard. The first data you will evaluate is the approximate time you will take to get to the other side of the boulevard. Second, you will approximate the time it takes for vehicles to reach your position. Finally, you could assess the consequences of not being able to cross the boulevard in time. So, you have just quantified the probability and the consequences of crossing the boulevard safely. Your decision? Cross the boulevard or wait for a gap in traffic? Which leads us to consider how to translate this trivial activity into your workplace. One can imagine several scenarios where a risk analysis will allow appropriate choices to be made to properly manage situations. In a situation of standardized tasks, such as an assembly line, it's easy to identify the different risks to which workers are exposed, quantify them, and develop an appropriate control plan. Risks are well known, do not vary much, and therefore a risk analysis usually only needs to be prepared once, with a process of continuous improvement to ensure that the risks remain at an acceptable level. Of course, it would be too easy if you only faced predictable, immutable risks. Let's think about a work situation that would involve risks that evolve over time, such as a construction site. You arrive in the morning to begin the tasks associated with the erection of reinforced concrete pillars. You determined that the risks associated with this work include the possibility of falls at heights, for example. So, you make sure that the scaffolding is secure, that the stairs are free of clutter, and are not slippery. In addition, you ensure that fall protection equipment is available, in good condition, and adequate for work. Everything is beautiful. Your risk analysis should prevent falls. You come back to the site the next day. The temperature dropped overnight below 0 degrees Celsius, and it falls a freezing rain. Is the risk analysis you completed the day before still valid? Up to a point, of course. However, the risk of falling will be affected by the freezing rain, of course. Therefore, precautionary measures will have to be reassessed to ensure that the risk becomes acceptable again. You will need to take a step back and find the right mitigation measures to work safely. We therefore realize that the risk analysis process should be seen as part of the work tasks in the same way as those you do on a day-to-day basis. In addition, this type of analysis is useful not only for the health and safety of employees, but can also be used for any situation where we must evaluate the different options, whether for production, quality, or the environment. Finally, risk analysis is also one of the methods to ensure that the work is managed in a way that is done with due diligence. But that will be the subject of another capsule. To learn more about this topic, please consult our e-learning platform and catalog, as well as our training and professional services in risk management.
Thank you.